Ask Tom on Home Show.
Nick from Manvel, Texas, has a little electric mystery going on.
He has suffered with it for probably the last year and a half, Tom. It's a horrible story. Nick writes, after living here 17 years, we had 18 months of trouble. Despite 40 Comcast visits and switching to satellite TV, our cable boxes repeatedly reboot from about 5 p.m. to 10 p.m. So it only happens in the evening, as far as he knows. We get about 5 minutes of television before the boxes reboot. We ran new lines, no change. Comcast said there's a voltage problem. An electrician came 3 times and could find no problem. They checked the panel, the grounds, the wiring, all looked good. No other appliances in the house are affected by this problem. But wait for this. He says, I ran an extension cord to a neighbor's house for our modem and satellite. No more reboots. Now, the crux of the problem here is that Nick's son is a gamer, and he says, I'm moving out if you don't fix this, Dad. Which I could argue could go either way, but
well,
what can you do?
Perfect.
Yeah. So what would you say, what kind of help can you offer, Nick?
Well, there's a lot of different things it could be and a lot of things that I would do. I would call the delivery people first. I would have them check every connection, if it's above ground or even below ground, to make sure there's no issues there going into your meter can box where you have probably a smart meter, most of us do now, and check all of that. That can get checked for free. So that would have been my very first call. Maybe he already did it because I'm sure he's been doing all kinds of stuff. Of course, you always call your Comcast, DirecTV, whatever it is, and get a new box. You want to blame the equipment. Everybody always does. Just have it switched out. And then, of course, you call an electrician. So he's done a lot of these things. I suspect it could be a lot of different things, and you should call someone to come out and double-check it and maybe has a little bit more knowledge on this. It could be anything from what we call an open neutral. And have you ever heard of people getting a little shocked in a shower or things like this? That happens from open neutrals where you have some neutrals crossed. And so you have to chase it down. And it could be something like that. It could be a grounding problem. But what I would do in the meantime, and Charlie, you were talking about conditioners and stuff in a different question earlier. I wonder, because in my own radio equipment, because this stuff is so sensitive, I have these battery packs that the equipment plugs into it plugs into the power, and it keeps the voltage and the current, or whatever you want to call it, nice and even all the time, so we don't get what we call package drops and this, like, well, we try not to, at least, throughout broadcasts and whatnot. We try our best. But I would tell you and maybe your son to invest in one of those battery packs for now and get someone like Will at Right Touch Electrical. Some electricians will take it a bit further and chase it down, but I suspect it could, you know, it happens from 5 to 10, which means everybody's coming home and turning everything on. So I suspect there's something happening in that time of day with the influx of electricity used in the neighborhood. And that's why I'd always start with the delivery system first.
Yeah, my suspicion would be to give Will a run at it because, you know, how many times do you get questions? I've had a roofer out 4 times, it still leaks. Like, well, guess what? Maybe the problem is you should try another roofer. And no offense to the electrician you have, but Will is a master electrician. Will has, and I will tell you, Tom, I mentioned this problem to Will, and he's said that open neutral idea. And he says, I know how to track that down. He said, so we want to try to get Nick and Will together on this and see if they can't work it out.
Well, I've known some electricians in my life that are just, and you probably know this in mechanics and everything else, any kind of career when it comes to this stuff, that just have a greater understanding. And so you've got to find those kind of people. And we always are here at Home Show Radio. I'm always trying to find them for my faculty at Texas Southmost College. You have to have someone that thinks past just the rules that you are given in the little box.
Exactly. And you can get past all those boxes by clicking the blue box on our home page. That'll take you to this page. That's the Ask Tom page. And Tom will answer your questions and help you out. And you can send pictures and videos and all that stuff. You've heard me say it before. But we post a new one of these every day because Tom likes to help. And you can help Tom help others because your problem might solve somebody else's problem after all. And you'll find all of our questions and answers posted at homeshowradio.com. The Home Show Radio Facebook page, and of course, the Home Show Radio YouTube channel.